In the era of minimal access surgery, am I right? This subspecialty, which was initially the domain of only senior consultants who traveled to other countries and came back, ordered their cases, and then gave really scarce access to younger surgeons, is now the topic of a conference directed exclusively for young surgeons. Just give that a thought. This is just how ubiquitous and widespread the subspecialty of minimal access surgery has become. Port closure is usually a topic that isn't given a lot of thought. It is very similar to how patient closure in most surgeries is left behind to the youngest resident on table, while all of the consultants and registrars de-wash. So a lot of times, urology and lab surgeries are, beta port bank kar dena, main thoda baar chai ke saath baitha hoon. So I'm going to take the next few minutes to talk to you about how port closures are extremely important, because minimal access surgery is here to stay. Now, MAS brought with it many promises. It brought early ambulation, lower infection rates, shorter hospital stays, and it also brought with it a promise of fewer hernias. Now, it's us surgeons who have actually been sacrificing on surgical principles when it comes to port closure, because it's a tiny incision, right? It doesn't merit that much attention. I am Eham Arora, and I come to you from Grand Medical College and from the Surgery Group of Hospitals in Bombay. And I'm going to tell you how you should not mess up port closures. Now, think about this device that is available widely in all of our ORs, port vehicle. Does it make sense that you are using a rapidly absorbable suture to close fascia? Think about it. How many of you guys over here are surgical residents? Quickly raise your hands. Okay? How many of you guys have done a laparotomy closure with Vicryl? With Vicryl? Laparotomy closure? See, pehle kam haath the, fir maine tone change kar liya, to aur haath kar liya. So it goes against surgical principles to use anything rapidly absorbable for fascia, because within 2 to 3 weeks the tensile strength will get away and eventually that facial weakness is going to give rise to a wound dehiscence. Now thankfully, companies are paying attention and they realize they are giving us substandard products. So this is a brand new suture that has recently become available. It's akin to port Vicryl, similar needle, similar short length, but it comes with delayed absorbable polydiaphragm nozzle. I am primarily a hernia surgeon, and this is usually what I see, port hernias. And they come to me more frequently because, like I said earlier, laparoscopic surgeries are becoming more common. There are some who feel that because the incisions are so small, they don't warrant closure or merit closure. People walk away not caring how well the closure has been taken care of. And then I see all of this, and this is now my primary business, handling small port size incisional hernias. Or you may mess up your port closure in completely different ways, catching bowel and omentum when you land up with this picture. Just look at how distended the bowel is. The port vehicle stitch has been taken through a loop of eyelid and the patient has landed up in post-op obstruction. Now, preoperatively, when you've convinced a patient about the various benefits of minimal access surgery, all of that has to be thrown into the dumps for this patient who will eventually require a laparotomy. Correct? It seems ironic. Most of the times, we don't check how well the port closure has been performed, but it helps to remember that we usually have more than one port through which we can insert a camera. So I'm going to show you how we perform the cholecystectomy port closure. Now you'll appreciate this is the epigastric port over here. This is of course at the end of the procedure. We take a very routinely available cobbler needle for a suture passer and we pass it at an angle to the port and introduce it inside. There's a 20 cm length of polydiaphragm delayed absorbable suture that is now brought out, and this end of the suture is attached to a hemostat. You angulate your cobbler needle in the opposite direction and you reintroduce it, and see, suddenly you have a U stitch on the abdominal wall. And honestly, it's as simple as that. It adds maybe 40 to 50 seconds to your entire procedure. You repeat it on the other side because this is a 10 millimeter port. And remember, this is not happening through any separate incision. This is happening through the port incision in the epigastric. And you repeat, so in essence now I have two U sutures along the epigastric port, but don't pull out the port just yet. Remove your camera port instead, which is in the umbilicus. Now, of course, here we are using a port vicryl because that's what's easily available, but I'm hoping we shift to PDN soon. We used to allies forceps to grasp the fissure really well. The assistant over here plays a very vital role because they are the people with the two forceps and the hemostats who are catching the tip of this short stout needle, ensuring the needle does not disappear into the abdominal cavity. For a small incision around the umbilicus, usually a figure of eight will suffice, but there are cases where we have had to increase the incision to extract an infected or enlarged gallbladder. So you may want to take interrupted sutures, or conversely, you can even do this with an aneurysm needle. But I don't suggest that because the aneurysm needle leaves a big hole in the fissure that eventually needs to be closed. Now see, importantly, the sutures are being made snug, but we are not tying them off. We insert the camera through the epigastric port and we check whether the port closure is okay. Have we not taken complete bites, or is the bowel or omentum that is stuck underneath? If it is, remember, we've not tied the suture off, you just have to loosen it, put one instrument inside, sweep the umbilical area clean, and you're done. At the end, you withdraw your epigastric port and then you tie off the PDF sutures that we had taken earlier. So in a simple way, without using any special instrumentation that is routinely available in the OR, you securely closed off your epigastric and umbilical ports.